provide administration to go over how to create group emails with Infinite Campus. And since we just had mid-quarter grades go out, if you want to figure out how to send emails to all of your parents of kids that have D's and F's, that's what I'm going to show you. Okay? So I'll show you how to go through it. And then also on the back side, one side says grades group email and one side says group emails. Okay? Because there is just a little bit different. So let me just have an idea of who's following along with me. I'm going to try to put it together as I go and so I know. Okay. So if you would please open up Infinite Campus so that it's at this view. Right, because remember, Infinite Campus changed like a couple years ago and it looked a little bit different, but this is the view you want. It doesn't look, my whole screen doesn't pull up here. If it doesn't look like this, then you'll need to click here so that you're in instruction. Not Campus Tools, you definitely want to be in instruction. So from instruction, message center, and even if you have sent emails out before, you're just going to go to new, and from new, you want to switch to classified, you want to switch it to grades message. That's where the difference is between a general class message and a grades message. Grades message, and we say yes, you really want to do this, okay? Your user, you are a high school teacher, switch it down to high school teacher, because that will pull up your class. Okay, when you click on template, because I've done this before, I've saved mine, so I have different templates that are already here. Otherwise, if you just have grades, it will just be the grades template, and then you can add to it. Change this no sender to your email address. Whichever email address that you typically check, be sure you change that.
So mine has yours, so should I?
Yeah, mine does too. You're going to get a lot of emails.
So when I save it, it saves to everyone in the building?
Yes.
Sorry. I have no idea.
You're going to get a whole lot of
emails. Please don't use my email.
Whenever you click on it, it directs right to the teacher who made it.
Yeah.
So I'll give you guys a minute to change this, to personalize it for yours. I want to go ahead and let you do this, because then we're literally going to jump into how you assign it to go to only those kids that have D's and F's. I'm going to show you that in a minute, so go ahead and personalize yours. Yeah, I'll have to look at it. Yeah. But even if I did save as, if it saves it in there, I mean, Ann Herman has hers in there?
The Frau.
And Harland, yeah. Okay.
The Frau.
The Frau.
Hold on, so if it's those boxes, do we have
to? No, it will automatically do it.
Oh, okay.
It, when it goes to those students, it will generate that.
Gotcha.
Make one automatic. Once you have your email personalized for you, as Steve pointed out, you might want to click save as, and then you can have your own personal grades check saved. Janelle's left it. We want to use yours.
Can I still get an extra reward if I teach?
Could I have thought of anything else to put up there? Are we there? Are we ready to go to the next step? Okay, so then, I can click save as if I were you, but that's what I do. And save it, and then you want to go to next. Okay, so here we are at next. At the very top, you have to choose which class. Once upon a time, you can just choose multiple classes, but apparently that's not an option anymore. You have to redo this, and that's why you want to save your template. So you pick your class, and here, if you do the drop-down menu, my classes are high school rounding. That's what my grade count is, right? So this next drop box is high school rounding. Yeah. Here's where you can send who you want to send it. If the kids have only A's or B's or whatever, and so you can, if you only want to send this out to D and F parents, set up so it's only going out to D and F parents. And for grading tasks, that is quarter and IPR. Right now we're in progress, so we want the IPR, but sometimes I just click both. This is there's no harm in it, right? And then next, are we ready for next? And next. Okay, so then this will tell you how many people it's going out to. I only have one person. It sounds like that might be a mistake. So I'm going to go back and see if I missed something. All students, I'm just double checking. I've got it. The best. Well, right? I mean, right? You want to double check. Like, I always check how many emails are going out. And if it looks wrong, like, like 0 or 1, I'm thinking, did I miss something somewhere? Okay, so I still have it on the right class. It says semester 1, all students, not going to just specific students. Although if you wanted to just specific students, you can do that here. In progress, D's and F's, selected. Doesn't look like I missed anything.
Mine gives me the option to review my results. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, review results.
I've
already sent this out, so I don't want to hit send. But then again, here's your chance to double check everything. I always check recipient count, because maybe you have missed something. Maybe you didn't check IPR, you only checked quarter, and you don't have grades quarter yet. Or, you know, whatever, always check your recipient count. And then send. Then you're ready to do the exact same thing for your next class. And then you've sent all D's and F's emails.
What if
you're
just
going to
send a message about essays?
So if you want to send a message about essays, so that's the back side of this.
Oh, okay.
And it's...
I've done it before. That's amazing.
Yep. The only place where you need to change is message type. All the way back to when you click message, you want a class message, not a grades message.
Gotcha. Okay.
And if you click on class message, who knows? You might see emails I've created there too. I don't know.
So the only difference basically between class message and grades message is that you get the option to pick which student by their grade.
By their grade.
And other everything else works the same.
Everything else works the same. Yeah. And then this other side, I created a screen grab video, you know what I'm saying? And it showed me click here, you click here, you click here. So there's no sound. I don't think I'm talking on it, but if you ever want to watch it, you can watch it.
So in that last template, it just says if a student can earn a grade in the course, it doesn't indicate that it's a failing.
You can personalize it there.
Okay.
So if you were just going to send out to all D students who has earned a D, and you can personalize it there.
Okay.
It should go to the initial, the primary recipient. I'm not positive it goes to the kid or not. Yeah, which made me really worried that I didn't have one. Yeah, that looked wrong. But I can't see where else I'm going. Yes, right. Yeah, you yes.
Sometimes I use them kids on purpose. I sent it to both. There was on class message, there used to be. I haven't done one yet this year.